Savory foods are inherently delicious, but have you ever wondered why? In 1908, a Japanese professor pondered this question when exploring what made kelp broth taste so good. He recognized a unique taste in it that was different from the four well-known tastes of sweet, sour, bitter, and salty. It turns out that glutamate, an amino acid made by many plants and animals, was the source of this distinctive taste, which became known as umami, in reference to umai, the Japanese word for delicious. The professor isolated glutamate from seaweed to produce a crystallized salt form of glutamate, which combined one molecule of glutamate with the ion sodium to make it more tasty. This umami seasoning is still widely used today, and it's known as monosodium glutamate, or MSG. Glutamate is the most abundant amino acid found in nature, and it's one of the 20 amino acids that make up proteins in the human body. Because glutamate is synthesized as part of normal metabolism, it's considered a non-essential amino acid. In other words, we don't technically need to get it from food. Our bodies synthesize about 50 grams of glutamate each day, and store about 4.5 pounds of glutamate in major organs like the brain, muscles, kidneys, and liver. On average, we eat about 10 to 20 grams of glutamate each day, mostly from protein-containing foods like meat, cheese, nuts, and legumes. Whether it's consumed from food or MSG, glutamate is metabolized in the same way. In the saliva in the mouth, MSG separates into its two original parts, glutamate and sodium, and then glutamate binds to its receptors to elicit an umami, or savory, flavor sensation. In the stomach, there are more glutamate receptors, and these activate the vagus nerve. The vagus nerve notifies the brain that protein-rich foods have entered the stomach, and then the brain tells the stomach and the intestines to prepare for protein digestion. After leaving the stomach, glutamate enters the small intestine, where over 95% of the glutamate ingested is used as fuel by enterocytes, the epithelial cells of the gastrointestinal tract. The rest is absorbed into the bloodstream and delivered to cells to be used for metabolism or to make proteins. Now, it turns out that glutamate is also synthesized by the brain, where it acts as a neurotransmitter. Some people have speculated that MSG may enter the brain and even trigger migraine headaches. However, the glutamate we eat doesn't affect the amount of glutamate in our brain. This is because the glutamate we get from food is almost entirely utilized during its journey through the gastrointestinal tract. The blood-brain barrier prevents the small amount of glutamate in our bloodstream from entering the brain. Based on this aspect of human physiology, and confirmation in recent scientific reviews, the International Classification of Headache Disorders removed MSG from its list of headache triggers in 2018. Within food, glutamate is either bound, which means it's attached to other amino acids in the form of a protein, or it's just free by itself. The more free glutamate there is, the more umami flavor a food will have. Processes like aging or ripening will increase the amount of free glutamate in food. Take a deep red glossy tomato, for example. It will have more free glutamate than a firm pale one. Similarly, a cured ham will have more free glutamate than fresh pork. Seasoning a food with MSG also increases free glutamate. Some foods are very high in free glutamate. In 100 grams, kombu seaweed has 2,240 milligrams, marmite has 1,960 milligrams, and fish sauce has 1,383 milligrams. More common foods include Parmesan cheese, which has 1,680 milligrams, soy sauce, which has 1,264 milligrams, and oyster sauce, which has 900 milligrams. Some foods that may surprise you include walnuts, which have 658 milligrams, and tomatoes, which have 246 milligrams. Breast milk is also high in free glutamate, with its content varying by lactation stage and highest in mature milk. In fact, a breastfed infant consumes more free glutamate per pound of body weight than an adult. Overall, less than 10% of the glutamate we consume is in the form of umami seasoning, or MSG. After decades of research, MSG is considered safe by scientists and regulatory authorities around the world, including the United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization, the World Health Organization, and the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. In fact, MSG has been recognized as a tool to help people eat less salt, or sodium chloride. Consistently eating too much sodium can increase blood pressure, which may lead to hypertension, a top risk factor for cardiovascular disease. Which is why it's recommended that we limit sodium intake to less than 2,300 mg per day. But lower sodium foods aren't appealing to everyone, which makes this recommendation a tough one to meet. MSG has the potential to help with this, something noted in the 2019 Dietary Reference Intake Report for Sodium from the National Academies of Science, Engineering, and Medicine. Not only does MSG add flavor, but despite having sodium in its name, MSG contains 3 times less sodium by weight than table salt. For example, increasing glutamate content of foods while decreasing salt in a recipe can reduce the overall sodium content by up to 40%. Alright, as a quick recap, glutamate is the amino acid responsible for the flavor of umami and plays an important role in digestion by signaling for protein digestion and fueling the cells of the gastrointestinal tract. Our bodies make glutamate, and it's also present in a variety of whole foods. Glutamate can also be added by seasoning foods with MSG. In the saliva in the mouth, MSG separates into glutamate and sodium, which is why the body doesn't differentiate between the glutamate in umami seasoning and the glutamate in everyday foods. Extensive research has shown that MSG is safe to consume, doesn't cause headaches, and could be a helpful tool for lowering the amount of sodium that people eat.